We're on to the next speaker. I'll take
Prossimo
a little bit of time to apologize for technical hiccups. We have a great team up there.
We got
a bit unlucky on something.
Purtroppo
and
siamo stati sfortunati
we're going to cut short a little bit our lunch break. But also, if you have to walk outside, you'll see that we are building.
Stiamo
building lots of stuff
costruendo tantissime
from
cose,
October to,
perché
gonna
dal 2 ottobre avremo una grande fiera. Una grande fiera che è la European Maker Fair.
Until now, and
che sarà la
so
più grande
there
mai organizzata,
inventions
e
and
ci saranno
lots
delle invenzioni, tantissime
and
cose interessanti, persone interessantissime
to,
vi incoraggio a venire.
Il prossimo relatore,
abbiamo parlato appunto
best practices,
di
how to use
migliori
data
prassi,
for
come usare i dati
and,
per la trasparenza,
actually, our
e
next
questa è un'esperienza interessante.
Well, she's Italian, but she has just come back from
italiana,
New York, where
this
next project, Open Coesione, just won an international award.
Open
so we have
un
very great experience to share with the rest of the world. And now
Alin
Penisi is
going to
tell us more about it.
Che ci può dire esattamente di cosa si tratta. Grazie.
So hello, thank you Antonella
buongiorno,
for the introduction and you all to be here today with us.
Grazie per essere qui con noi
I love people bragging about our project, like the people who gave us this wonderful prize at the Open Government Partnership. Why? Because it reminds
progetto,
me every day of the responsibility we have in trying to make this project work. Part of this project has to do with open data, the biggest part of this project, and actually I want to tell you that what was interesting for me in this New York experience was the fact that this was the only project awarded for citizen engagement that had to do with open government data. All the others were very interesting projects that have to do with engaging citizens with governments and politics, but we're not using open data. And what we try to do in this project, one of our big challenges, is to try to engage people on data. What is this project about? It's about tracking about more than 800,000 projects which are funded by European Structural Funds in Italy and another big national fund which main aim is to try to reduce disparities between regions, to attract businesses and make regions full of better opportunities for businesses and citizens. We're talking about 80 billion euro which are assigned to these projects, only 32 billion spent by now on a 7-year cycle. Actually, this is one of our big policy challenges in Italy. Spending this money, and we're talking about 40 public administrations which are involved in deciding on these projects and devolving the funds, and over 80,000 public and private bodies which actually use the funds, implement these projects. This project, therefore, is about, first of all, opening administrative records, records that have to do with information that administrations use and have to produce to be able to spend these funds. And the idea, obviously, is a transparency idea, be able to improve decision-making and policy design by having bigger scrutiny of all of this data. This data was, and for a long time, within public administration, but usually people would discuss in the kind of data that was, let's say, publicly accessible on the data was just aggregate data, not the information on every single project. The idea is that learning from these single projects, where they are, who gets the money, we can learn a lot more, and we can also encourage the creation of a new kind of citizen engagement that puts pressures on the administrations to spend these funds in the best way possible. So the first part of this project has to do with finding out, giving the possibility of everyone to find out. And actually, I want to tell you that one of the lessons learned from this project at the moment is that not only in general people find out, we have about 2 million page views by now since July 2012 when the project was open, when the website, the portal was open at least, and we have about 500,000 visitors, 80% of them which come back to the portal, to the website in time. But so as I was saying, the first part of this project is to find out about these policies and what kind of information do we give. We give information on what the project is about, detailed information on the amount of financial aid received and what kind of sources of financing are involved. Many of these projects have to do with multiple funding sources, the location where in Italy this project is, the policy sector. These policies, development policies, range from building big infrastructure to very small educational projects in schools. They range from helping startups, innovation and research, to conservation of cultural heritage. So many different things. So we give an idea of the type of the project and the type of, actually, the recipients and the public body who is responsible for devolving the funds. And we give information on the expected timing of the project to be completed. But not only aggregate information, which is a way to invite people to have a look at these projects, but information on every single project, as I said again, which is updated every 2 months. So the second idea of Open Coesione is to allow people to follow in time these projects and see how they develop. And also to follow the recipients, the people who are actually receiving these funds, with numerous kinds of problems that people like Chris are familiar with, that is identifying correctly, uniquely, many different private companies which are involved. We give a number of graphical visualizations, and we also offer open data databases that can be downloaded with more than 100 variables characterizing each project that is reported on the web portal. And part of our project, though, is also helping people understand the data to press forward. One of the branches and directions that Open Coesione recently took is that of inviting people to organize marathons, but not hackathons, marathons, not technological marathons, but civic society marathons, monitoring marathons. The idea is offering people a place, a debate, an area where they can actually learn what these projects look like on insight. So we invite communities, associations who might have some feeling that in their local community these projects could be more interesting, could be better for them, or could work better. And we ask them to actually, let's say, investigate on these projects, go have a look, photograph them, follow them in time. We can only, the government, give them data on what we have, which is the administrative records, the financial work. We don't have that much information on what the projects actually look like. This is an opportunity for us, too, to learn what the projects really look like and to involve people on a discussion on each single project. So citizens, usually local communities, we have about 52 projects which are being regularly monitored by associations on the territory. Go and venture a project, find it on the Open Coesione website, give us a more precise address, for example, for this project, because we might only have the municipality where the project is actually located, but not the exact address. They might take photographs of the project, interview people who are responsible for deciding what this project should be about, the aims, and trying to understand whether these aims are being met. A big civil engagement, let's say. Now, the other idea behind this project is trying to raise a new generation of civic awareness. This is what we do with Monithon as well, giving people a Ushaidi, basically, based website where they can upload information on what they see these projects in reality being. But of course, we think that to do this, people have to be sort of educated to a new way of looking at the responsibility in society. Open data is about governments giving out public data to everyone. You can do lots of things with data. But if we want people to use this data, to be interested in what happens around them and to learn from this data, we have to give them a number of tools, not only tools for understanding data, but tools maybe for understanding that being a citizen is not only something about voting. By the way, voting is not very popular anymore, apparently, in many, many places in the world, at least in our societies. So maybe it's about engaging in a different way in your local community. We are trying to aim to 100 schools this year for an experimental project that started last year. In high schools, a special, let's say, program of digital competences and civic awareness has been set up. Students learn about their territory. They look at data with indicators to understand what their city looks like when it's translated into data, into measurements that are usually used to describe these places for someone who is not there. They try to relate to this data with their personal experience of living in a certain place, in a certain town. And what they do is that they embrace a project of data storytelling, which selects an area, a theme, or selects a branches of these public investment projects which are in their town. They follow this project along the school year, accompanied by their teachers, who might decide to use this as an opportunity for more mathematics or to use it as an opportunity for more history of the art, for example. And at the end of the school year, they present this project of the results, basically, of what they have discovered or what they have done, using also the Monithon platform to tell other school children or to tell, in some cases, even the mayor what they have found. So what we hope, and we hope this will be a way to contribute to it, although, of course, our main aim is that of giving data, we hope to contribute also to raising a new generation of people who will use that data in the future. Thank you.